The companion woman who was an expert in fikr, the woman called as a virtuous, and the woman who was a reason of many verses in the Holy Quran. Yes, Ummu Salama.
Ummu Salama radiallahu anha, born into the famous Banu Maksum tribe in Arabia, her real name was Hind bint Abi Umayya. Her father was Banu Umayya and Athika bint Amr was her mother. Ummu Salama's first marriage was to Abdullah bin Abdul Asad, known as Abu Salama. With the advent of Islam, both of them believed in Islam and joined the Prophet. Ummu Salama and Abu Salama were one of four couples when the first Islamic exodus went to Abyssinia. Therefore, she has the distinction of being the first woman to perform the Hijrah. Both their lives were very difficult in the beginning of Islam. Abu Salama was seriously injured in the clash at Uhud and died a few months later. Ummu Salama was a mother of four children at that time. After her husband's death, she spent her life disciplining her children. After that, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and Umar Farooq radiallahu anhu proposed for marriage, but she refused.
The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam proposed marriage to Ummu Salama and she agreed to that. It appears that Allah has made realistic on Abu Salama's prayer to compensate Ummu Salama with a better husband after his demise.
She lived with the Prophet for a long time. It is reported that about 380 hadiths have been narrated by her. Ummu Salama was the foremost wife in knowledge after Aisha radiallahu anha. The companions used to approach her for reassurance and clarify doubts. Ummu Salama was fortunate enough to be the cause to win the Treaty of Hudaybiyah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started visiting his wives, beginning from Ummu Salama. She was a motive for the revelation of many verses in the Holy Quran. She was also able to make mark in the field of knowledge. Hafiz al-Dahabi remarked of Ummu Salama that she was one of the companion women who were experts in fikr. In that sense, Ummu Salama radiallahu anha received great respect among the wives of the Prophet. She was considered to be an expert in the female-oriented issues. In the 61st year of Hijrah, on the reign of Yazid bin Muawiyah, she bid farewell to the world and was 84 then. Abu Hurairah proceeded over her janazah prayer and was buried at Jannat al-Baqi near to Fatima radiallahu anha. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praised his beloved wife saying, "You are virtuous." She showed constant interest in shaping the learning culture of her children. That is how Ummu Salama's daughter Zainab became an eminent scholar of jurisprudence at that time, who used to recite the Quran extensively and would have meditated on the Quranic concepts. Ummu Salama was a wife of a learned scholar who clearly copied the housework of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the believers. The Prophet said he used to advise prominent companions, and companions such as Umar, Usman, Ali and Aisha, and they would stand and act accordingly. It is not just a matter of saying that Allah is with us. It is a great personality who has shown that life is meant to be reflected in time of crisis.